The aim is to develop a concrete product which utilizes more than 50% fly ash as replacement of cement without an additional cost and without any additional procedures or major changes to the actual production process.
Fly ash actually is a waste material which comes out of the coal-fired power stations. So here in this project we are mainly looking at using the fly ash as replacement, cement replacement in concrete. Cement is a pollutant because when we produce 1 ton of cement, the industry emits about 1 ton of carbon dioxide. At the moment, the global cement production is more than 3 billion tons. That means 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide is emitted into the atmosphere.
The really interesting thing about fly ash is that somebody has discovered that when you add it into a concrete mix, it actually improves the thermal performance. It improves the sort of ability of the plastic nature of concrete to sit into a form. The ability for fly ash as a completely recycled waste product that's being brought into a brand new material actually helps in the way in which it improves the performance of that material. So effectively the concrete is better with the fly ash in it rather than it not being in it. And I suppose the work that's being done at RMIT is bound within the kind of chemical composition and the ways in which this performance might be assessed.
We have solved some of the immediate barriers that were inhibiting the use of the material widely. So we have figured out a way of using ultrafine fly ash so that we could produce concrete using normal production processes with high volumes of fly ash. So recently in Docklands, it was a condition that 20% fly ash is used in concrete.
Fly ash was used in this project because I guess it was part of the suite of options under the Green Building Council rating tool. The gauge in itself is a commercial office building. It's the first building in the country to achieve a 6-star design, a 6-star as-built, and a 6-star fit-out. 9,000 square metres of commercial office lettable area and a number of attributes that have helped it get to its 6-star rating. Fly ash itself is a waste product and we worked with a number of different partners within the industry to try and work out how we could actually use it.
Now, with people like Clinton and the C40 conference recently, we're beginning to see the way in which both legislators and big business are embracing the ability for sustainability to not only promote their brand, but begin to actually increase the quality of life in significant cities.
I thank the property developers and the local governments that are involved in this. Individually, these projects are going to transform their communities, but collectively, they will set a new global benchmark that can change the world.
There was a lot of myths in the industry that said that building green cost extra and that to build a green building you paid a premium. We were very, very clear about the fact that we wanted to achieve a 6-star result at a commercially viable rate. But I guess that's comparing it to perhaps a 3 or 4 or 4.5-star building.
The research will benefit the industry mainly. Cement is more expensive compared to fly ash. So industry, I believe, would be very happy to use this product.
I think this collaborative act between industry, government and the everyday person, where the everyday person makes particular demands of their elected representatives to enforce the ability for buildings and spaces and cities to grow in a sustainable manner, which goes beyond a kind of throwaway strap-on gimmick and starts to get really down to the core of how these places are good places to be.